Hello everyone, in this video we are going to talk about overlapping subproblems. We say that two subproblems of a larger problem are overlapping if these two problems are exactly same. Now, overlapping subproblems is used a lot in dynamic programming. In fact, it is one of the indicators to indicate that a dynamic programming solution is applicable for a particular problem or not. Let us look into overlapping subproblems by taking example of Fibonacci series. We know that Fibonacci series, the nth term of Fibonacci series is equal to sum of n minus 1th term and n minus 2th term. So this is the Fibonacci series. In this series, each term is equal to sum of previous two terms. First two terms are 1 and 1, and all other terms are equal to sum of previous two terms. So 2 is equal to 1 plus 1 is 2, 1 plus 2 is 3, 2 plus 3 is 5, 3 plus 5 is 8, 5 plus 8 is 13, and so on. So if we write it in terms of function, then we say that nth term of Fibonacci is equal to n minus 1th term plus n minus 2th term. The conversion of this statement into a function is straightforward. Compute the nth term of Fibonacci. We will call the function for n minus 2th term and n minus 1th term. So computation of nth term or n minus 1th term or n minus 2th term are problems of the exact same type. So the function call is recursive. So nth term of Fibonacci is equal to sum of n minus 1th term plus n minus 2th term with a terminating condition that if n is equal to 1 or n is equal to 2, then return 1 hard coded. If we look at the function call tree, and so let us start with 1. To compute the first term of Fibonacci, function will be called only once. To compute the second term of Fibonacci also, function is called only once. Because if n is equal to 1 or n is equal to 2, then we are just returning 1. To compute the third term, and for n is equal to 3, for n is equal to 3, we will be calling the function with n is equal to 1 and n is equal to 2. So function is called thrice. If we want to compute, so till now there is no overlapping subproblems, because each of the subproblem is unique. The problem here is to compute the third term, and to compute the third term we are computing the first term and second term, so there is no overlap till now. But if we want to compute the fourth term of Fibonacci, then to compute the fourth term of Fibonacci we require the third term and the second term. So third term will be computed. To compute the third term, we again require first and second, and we also require to compute the second term. Now there is a slight overlap that function will be called for n is equal to 2 twice. Function will be called for n is equal to 2 here as well as here. If we are computing the fifth term of Fibonacci, then for n is equal to 5, we will be calling the function again for n is equal to 4 and n is equal to 3. So to compute the fourth term of Fibonacci, function will be called 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times, and then we will again be computing the third term of Fibonacci. To compute the third term of Fibonacci, we will again be calling the function for n is equal to 1 and n is equal to 2. So this way we are having the overlap that for this third term is computed again. So these three function calls are exactly same as these three function calls. So probably if we have already computed the third term of Fibonacci, then we should have used the previously computed value rather than computing the value again. Now, as the value of n increases, this overlapping subproblem starts to get more severe. For n is equal to 6, we will be calling the function with n is equal to 5 and then n is equal to 4. So basically, to compute the sixth term of Fibonacci, we will be computing the fifth term and the fourth term. To compute the fifth term of Fibonacci, we are calling the function like this, these many times. And then we will be computing the fourth term of Fibonacci. To compute the fourth term of Fibonacci, we will again be calling the function these many times. So these two problems are exact overlaps. So five function calls are exactly same as these five function calls. So to compute the sixth term of Fibonacci, the total number of function calls are 5 plus 5, 10 plus 3, 13 plus 1, 14 and 1 for 6, 15. So So function will be called 15 times, right? Whereas we are just computing the sixth term of Fibonacci. So recursion in itself has some challenges that, you know, recursive solutions usually end up taking more time and more memory. This is because the activation record of the function, or the stack frame of the function as we call it, the stack frame of the function gets created multiple times, because of which it ends up taking more time and more memory. Here, it is not just about recursion, it is also about overlapping subproblems where a function is called again and again. Let us see it running. This is the function Fibonacci. I have used a global variable. Using global variable is not a good idea, but this is just for demonstration. So we have used a global variable, function count, which will tell us how many times the function is called. So the name of the variable is function call count. And each time the function is called, we will increment this function call count variable. Now let us find the first term, second term, third term, fourth term, and so on. 10th term, n is equal to 20, 20th term, 25th term, 30th term, and 40th term. So each time we are computing the term, we are resetting the value of function call count before calling the Fibonacci function. So we are resetting the value of function call count, and then we are printing in one line, we are printing first the term which we are computing. For example, if we are computing the fifth term, then we are printing 5 first, then the actual term of Fibonacci, and then we are printing the number of times the function is called. Let us try to run this function. So when we run this function, we see that when n is equal to 1, the function is called only once. So in this output, the third term, this term, is actually tells us the number of times function is called. The second term tells us the actual Fibonacci value. So the first term is 1, second term is also 1, third term is 2, fourth term of Fibonacci is 3, fifth term of Fibonacci is 5, sixth term of Fibonacci is 8, seventh term is 13, and so on. We are not interested in the term per se. What we are interested in is the number of function calls. So function is called, let me just copy this output. And paste it here. So if we look at it, then when n is equal to 5, then the function is called 9 times. So this can be verified, that when n is equal to 5, the function is called 9 times, which is 1, then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. When n is equal to 6, the function is called 15 times. When n is equal to 7, the function is called 25 times. When n is equal to 8, the function is called 41 times. When n is equal to 9, 67 times. So if we are computing the 20th term of Fibonacci, then the function is called actually 13,000 times, which is very large. And similarly, if we are computing 40th term of Fibonacci, then the function is called almost 200,000 times, which is almost 20 crore times. So it is a huge overhead, not just on memory, but also on time. So this is the problem that we are talking about. So this is only because of overlapping subproblems, because we are trying to compute each term again and again. For example, if we are not computing one term again and again, and if we are storing the term in some cache memory, let us say when fifth term of Fibonacci is first computed, then we store the fifth term of Fibonacci in a cache, and then we use this cache memory, we use this already computed value of the of Fibonacci of 5, rather than recomputing Fibonacci of 5 again, then we can reduce this total time taken by a huge margin. So we will see in the next video how we can use a cache and we can reduce this number of function calls drastically. For more such videos and insight into the internals of the programming, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you.